Blackstone Audio presents Everyone in Their Place, The Summer of Commissario Ricciardi by Maurizio de Giovanni, translated by Anthony Sugar. This book is read by Grover Gardner. Dedication to Tita and Vale, fellow travelers who've gone the whole distance. 1. The angel of death made its way through the festa, and nobody noticed. It passed close to the wall of the church, which was still decorated from that morning's religious celebration. By now, though, night had fallen, and the sacred had given way to the profane. A bonfire had been set in the middle of the piazza, in keeping with tradition, even though the brutal heat of August left everyone breathless. And no one needed those flames dancing over the pile of old wood that every family in town had contributed. But the flames proved useful to the angel of death, casting the shadows of couples as they danced merrily to the sound of tambourines, guitars, and clapping hands, accompanied by the shouts of children and the whistles of strolling vendors. The angel hadn't foreseen it, but it knew that divine justice would intervene in some way. A firecracker exploded, followed by another. Midnight was approaching. A fat, perspiring woman pretended to faint, and the man next to her laughed. The angel of death brushed past him, touching his elbow, but the man didn't even shiver. It wasn't his turn, not that night. Skirting the edge of the piazza in a nondescript black outfit, there was nothing about the angel that could have attracted notice, save perhaps the sadness of the downcast eyes and the slight droop of the shoulders. That, too, was something it had counted on. It reached the front door of the palazzo, and for a moment feared it might have been locked for the festa. But no, it had been left open just a crack, as always. The angel of death slipped inside, shadow-like, as the tarantella built to a crescendo, and the crowd accompanied the dance with song and applause, and firecrackers crackled, keeping time to the music. It knew just where to hide. It reached the narrow gap behind a pillar, took up a position, and settled in to wait. Its hand slid into its pocket and touched the cold metal, but it brought no comfort, nor did the courtyard's solitary shadows bring comfort of any kind. Nothing did, except the thought of the justice that would soon be meted out. 2. Commissario Luigi Alfredo Ricciardi didn't mind working on Sundays, and that was just another of his quirks. His colleagues came up with excuse after excuse to get out of Sunday duty every time shifts were being assigned. They had sick mothers to care for, seniority accrued, alleged family emergencies. Any excuse would do as long as they could skip working the one day of the week that the whole city rested. But Ricciardi said nothing, as usual, and so, as usual, he was stuck with the worst assignments. Not that the fact won him any goodwill from his fellow policemen. In fact, they took every chance that presented itself to whisper venomously behind his back. He was a solitary soul, his hands always in his pockets, invariably hatless, even in winter. He never attended parties or drank toasts. He was always somewhere else when people gathered. He let invitations lapse, he failed to form friendships, and he was never open to the confidences of others. His green eyes glittered in his dark face, a lock of hair unfailingly draping across his forehead, only to be swept away from time to time with a sharp gesture. He spoke only seldom, and then with a cool irony that most failed to understand. Still, his presence never failed to attract attention. He worked tirelessly, especially when he was pursuing a murderer, indifferent to the vicious backbiting of those colleagues incapable of equaling the pace he demanded from all his investigators. The officers assigned to him cursed him under their breath for the hours he expected them to spend in the pouring rain or the hot blast of the noonday sun. He sent them out on seemingly endless and often futile stakeouts. They bitterly noted that on each case he worked, it was as if someone had murdered a member of his family, no matter whether the actual victim was an aristocrat or a pauper. On the other hand, nobody questioned his abilities. Without adhering to procedure or following the instructions issued by his superiors, he pursued his own incomprehensible twisting paths and always seemed to catch the culprit. Word had spread that Commissario Ricciardi spoke directly with the devil himself, and that the devil whispered to him the very thoughts that had been in the murderer's head.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.